everyone, and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Priya Mistry, and I'm a general dentist with a practice dedicated to taking care of patients with TMJ problems. Today's video is about tongue tie and nursing. This video is for fellow dental practitioners and for people that are just looking for more information, particularly new mothers who may be struggling with nursing. I hope this video can help shed some light onto why you may be struggling. So let's get right to it. What is a tongue tie? Underneath our tongues is a band of tissue called the frenum or the frenulum. This band of tissue tethers the tongue to the floor of the mouth. All of us have this band of tissue, so all of us have a frenum, but not all of us are tongue tied. A tongue tie is when this band of tissue is too tight or too restrictive, and it actually limits the mobility of the tongue. So the tongue needs a certain amount of mobility for nursing, chewing, speaking, swallowing, breathing, and proper tongue posture. And if that mobility is restricted and it affects those things negatively, then you have a tongue tie. So what is proper tongue posture? Proper tongue posture is when the tongue is up against the roof of the mouth with a light suction. So the tip of the tongue should be resting on that little pad of tissue behind our front two teeth, and the middle and the back of the tongue should be elevated up against the roof of the mouth, again, with a light suction. Proper tongue posture is so important because it helps to develop the palate. So when you have proper tongue posture at rest and when swallowing, it exerts forces onto the palate that help it develop to its full genetic potential. Proper tongue posture is also important for stimulation of cranial nerves and for the release of endorphins and growth hormones. So the benefits are enormous. And a tongue tie can prevent proper tongue posture because it doesn't allow the tongue to have the mobility to rest up against the roof of the mouth where it should be. So if a tongue tie can prevent proper tongue posture, it can also prevent all those benefits I just mentioned: stimulation of cranial nerves, release of growth hormones, release of endorphins, and growth of the palate to its full genetic potential. So all of those benefits can be negated, boom, right away, just by having a tongue tie. During nursing, the tongue also needs a certain amount of mobility. It needs to be able to elevate for a proper latch, and it needs to be able to move in a complicated peristaltic or wave-like motion for extracting adequate milk. So proper latch and getting adequate milk. If the tongue cannot do those things, then what happens is that the baby's latch is shallow and the baby is not getting enough milk. If the baby's not getting enough milk, mom is not producing enough milk. Additionally, if the latch is not adequate, then it can lead to a lot of pain with bleeding and blistering on the mother's end of this. So this is not the normal 3 to 4 out of 10 pain level that's associated with first-time moms trying to nurse. It's an 8 to 10 out of 10 pain level, again, with bleeding, blistering. It's emotionally and physically very distressing on the mother and the baby when this happens. A tongue tie is a genetic trait that's passed on. So back a few hundred years ago, when there were no bottles, there was no formula, if a baby couldn't nurse, it would not make it. Or if it did make it to adulthood, that baby would grow up into probably kind of a sickly child and be very unlikely to pass on their genes or procreate. So essentially, the tongue tie gene wasn't being passed on that much back then. Now, with the invention of formula, with the invention of bottles, that gene is being passed on much more frequently, much more commonly. Now, babies that have tongue ties are able to thrive and grow to adulthood, which is great. Additionally, a few hundred years ago, midwives used to keep a long fingernail. The reason for that long fingernail is after a baby was born, the midwife would then observe the nursing process. And if the mother was having a ton of pain, and if the baby was not getting enough milk or falling asleep too frequently while nursing, the midwife would then suspect a tongue tie. And she would use that nail to then reach under the tongue and release that restricted tissue. So I know what you're thinking. A fingernail is not the most hygienic way to go about this, and I totally agree. But the point of me saying this is that there used to be an awareness of tongue tie in the community that's just not as prevalent in the medical community these days. So to summarize, the tongue tie gene is being passed on more frequently now than ever before, and there's less of an awareness in the medical community of what a tongue tie is than ever before. So you'll be happy to know that to treat a tongue tie in modern times, a fingernail is not used. Most commonly, a laser is used, and the procedure is very quick, usually 10 to 15 seconds long or so, and there's very minimal bleeding associated with it. After the tongue tie is released, the infant is immediately given back to its mother and nursing ensues. And nursing is the best way to calm a finicky baby, so that's why it's best just to nurse right after that tongue tie is released. And mothers notice a much better latch, much less pain, and the baby's getting more milk immediately. So it's a quick procedure with amazing benefits to it. The mother is also given some simple exercises to do with baby for a few weeks after the tongue tie release. These exercises allow the tissue to heal in a way that allows maximum mobility for the tongue. So it's setting the baby up for success from infancy onwards, because a tongue tie, again, affects so many things: nursing, chewing, speaking, swallowing, breathing. And again, all the benefits of proper tongue posture come along with this as well. If you're a mother that's struggling or looking for more information, there are so many practitioners throughout the United States that are skilled and qualified in releasing tongue ties. So a simple search on Google should help you find someone in your area. If you live in Southern California, the Breathe Institute is wonderful. You're so lucky to have them nearby. If you're in the Pacific Northwest, Dr. Bobby Gaheri is equally wonderful. And if you're in Alabama, you have Dr. Richard Baxter, who's devoted his life's work to this. And he has also written a book called Tongue Tied, adequately named. This book was a wealth of information to me when I read it, and it really changed the way I saw things, the way I practice general dentistry, the way I practice at my TMJ practice. It's just been enormously helpful. So dental practitioners, people looking for more information, I've linked this book below. Please read it when you have some time. I promise you won't regret it. One of the reasons I feel so passionately about this topic is because I was unable to nurse both of my children due to undiagnosed lip and tongue ties. I was told the pain will go away, you need to toughen up, you'll get through it, and I knew something was wrong because I was in so much pain and my babies just weren't getting enough milk. They weren't growing, they weren't gaining weight, and they were falling asleep while nursing. But what's unfortunate is that I didn't have the knowledge then that I have now. I truly believe that all pediatricians and all lactation consultants should have this information and should use it to help mothers and babies nurse efficiently and effectively. So if you've liked what you've heard, if you've learned something, click like below, subscribe to my channel. There's so much more to come. I've already released a video on just what tongue tie is and how tongue tie is related to TMJ disorders. I'll be releasing more videos in the future about how tongue tie is connected to mouth breathing, to diagnoses of ADD and ADHD, to sleep apnea. There's so much to come, and I hope to see you all soon. Please subscribe, and I'll see you guys later.